It's 9:05. It feels like it's getting unhealthy now.
What's going on, guys? My name is Jake Moscato, and over the next 7 days, I will not be allowed to eat a single piece of food.
Hey, what do you think you're doing? This one's for you.
All right, Doc. So can this be dangerous?
Yeah, absolutely. Headaches, nausea, vomiting, lightheadedness, shakiness. You're gonna feel weak. You know, you're probably gonna lose a lot of muscle as well.
Obviously, everybody's heard of intermittent fasting.
Let's come up with the ideal intermittent fasting.
My first meal is at 2 p.m.
And then now the new diet is don't eat for 18 hours.
You know? I know, isn't that crazy?
But I've also been seeing the popularity of longer form fasting increase.
What's the longest you fast for?
Like no food, just water, liquids.
Yep.
Like 42 days, I did about three of them.
42 days?
Did he just say 42 days? All right, here are the rules. I can only drink water, coffee, tea, and I can have electrolytes. Shout out Bear Performance Nutrition for sponsoring this video, and shout out DexaFit.
Let's go.
Normalizing your diet.
Let's go.
I'll be doing a full DEXA scan before and after to let you guys know changes in body weight, muscle mass, and body fat. And then I'm also gonna be doing physique updates every single day to see how shredded I can actually get.
Why did I do that? It's currently 8:15 a.m. Day one. I did exactly what you shouldn't do before you're doing a fast. I'm hungover. I went out last night to like the best Italian food spot in the world. You shouldn't eat veal parmesan and spaghetti and meatballs before doing a 7 day fast, because from what I understand, I spiked my blood sugar.
Normally, every single morning, I'd be doing coconut water. But today, and for the next 7 days, this is it. All right, so I'm here with Starbucks, my boy Sindel. Yo, used to train back in the day.
7 day fast, I hope he makes it.
It's 7 day fast.
This shit's gonna be hard as hell.
Yes, it is. You know, I can drink coffee though.
I believe in you.
Just finished up a run, probably a really stupid idea, but I had to work off that veal parmesan last night. I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little nervous. Up until today, this was just a concept, and now I have to really do it. Truthfully, I normally do intermittent fasting every day anyway, so I normally don't eat until like 4, 5, 6 o'clock anyway. So it's about 1 p.m. right now. So 80 hours left, or I'm not good at math, but I'll update you later. It's 3 o'clock. I just finished stretching and meditating and all that. This is about the time where I go inside, have a banana and some peanut butter and start working. And I can't have one. And I want a banana really bad. It's 5 o'clock. Just kind of finished work. I'm hungry. I am hungry. It's 7:30 p.m. I'm already looking forward to that first meal, that bone broth or that coconut water in 7 days after the DEXA scan. Such a stupid idea being here. I blame him.
Cousin!
All right, end of day one. I'll probably give it one more update right before I go to bed, but this fucking jerk off. Look at, hold up. Just. Mm. 3:23 a.m. Just woke up. I'm not sure if this is fast related. My right leg was completely numb. So I woke up in a panic, tried to get feeling in it again. It's pretty hilarious and stupid that I'm doing this basically with no supervision.
Morning two, my stomach won't stop growling.
No. Goddamn tree. Come on, tree. Little Barnes & Noble rip? What? I need some to do. I mean, you know, they said part of the fast is supposed to be spiritual, so gotta get my spiritual book for the day.
The amount of times I've looked forward to eating something, like, oh, I can go eat now. And I'm like, oh, wait,
no, I can't. I just looked at dog food, and it looked very, very enticing. It's where I'm at.
Yo, it's such a shitty feeling when it's like 3 o'clock and you're kind of closing in on being done with work and you think about dinner. Forget about the food, just the hour. What do I do with that hour now?
This is crazy.
It's 5 p.m. day two. I don't feel good. I just had my first heart palpitations. It sounds so stupid, but I really am like willing to die to get this done. Finishing up day two here. I felt really bad before. Like I'm talking like I was gonna quit, like very close to. Then I had a electrolyte packet, which I wanted to pull out later. I wanted to see how long I can go without taking proper electrolytes. I actually feel good right now. I feel really good. It's really confusing because I felt like death before. Probably somewhere around hour 48. It's like right now, to be honest with you, I'm really not that hungry, but I just had the instinct of going to ShopRite and getting food. Like I can't tell you the amount of times I passed the peanut butter in my kitchen today and the habit I have of just going to grab peanut butter and me not being able to do it. So I'm starting to see like there's a difference between hunger and boredom and habits. Day three morning. I feel good, but anxious as fuck. But good anxious.
Getting a little work done, you feel me?
We're having a day. Yo, I'm telling you, I'm not stopping unless I'm at the fucking emergency room. Let's go.
Also, I really wanted to update, like, I really wanted to track my sleep and my heart rate.
Doesn't look like it's charging. Just got it. It doesn't look like it's working, so.
Bummer. Whoop. Come on.
Day three, midday, I think like 3 p.m., 4 p.m. I'm not hungry, so I'm on hour 65, 60, something like that. I'm not hungry, so I don't know how that's possible, but I'm not hungry. That hydration packet yesterday, I think, helped a lot. From what I understand, I think the hardest part is over. I think my body should be fully in ketosis. So yeah, see you in a little bit.
It's 5:45. p.m. Sorry, Lord of the Rings is on. It's 5:45 p.m. I feel euphoric, which I'm fucking pumped about.
Day four, I'm at the gym. Yo, I am getting shredded, like shredded to the bone. Yo, day four, I feel incredible. I'm not hungry. I'm not gonna sit here and say that like I feel extremely focused, but at times like I have felt euphoric. And I think the hard part of this is done. I think I'm like 100 hours in or something. Yeah, I feel amazing. I don't know. Let's go.
Okay, so probably too much information. It's day four. I haven't pooped yet. So I'm going to pack a lip. And by pack a lip, I mean throw a Zen in and drink some green tea. And hopefully I can go to the bathroom. I mean, I haven't had to go to the bathroom. I'm not saying I've had stomach problems. It's like bathroom doesn't exist anymore. I'm actually confused because I'm like, where is the weight going? Like, I see I'm dropping weight, but like, where is the weight going? Am I peeing it out? Like, is it secreting through the sweat in my body when I sleep? Like, yeah, I don't know. Also, I'm gonna go check my weight right now and see if that changed because I haven't checked it. So, yes, I'll update you there.
So when I started the challenge, I was at 208.8 pounds. Now I'm at, so we'll see. That's crazy, bro.
Dude, I'm down like 7 pounds.
7 pounds?
So, I just pooped. I just went to the bathroom and nothing really came out.
Yo,
this is crazy. The only reason why I'm able to do this fast, from what I understand, is that so the average person takes in about 1800 calories per day, right? 1 pound of body fat is 3500 calories. So the reason why I'm able to fast is because my body is strictly burning fat now. So if you think about it, if I have 30 pounds of body fat on me, if 1 pound of body fat is 3500 calories and I need 1800 calories a day to survive, that means that I'll probably be burning something. My fuel for these 7 days is literally my fat, my body fat. And that's why I'm like fucking deezing up over here, because all my fat is just coming off. From what I understand, if you have like 100 pounds of fat on you, 200 pounds of fat on, you can just fast forever. Getting the taste of these freaking electrolytes after not eating. To feel something sweet and then a little bit of salt.
One thing I'm realizing about food, you don't even realize how social it is. Like I was hanging out with friends last night and I couldn't. There's so much. It's fun to like cook food with people. It's fun to go to eat with people. It's fun. Like you remove that and then it's boring. I'm bored. Like I'm watching college football right now. Kind of wish I had like, I don't know, like some beef jerky or something. Just, you know, something to, maybe some pineapples or something to snack on. Like I'm definitely going to enjoy just like the act, like not even let's just the act of getting food once this whole thing is done. End of night four. It's such a depressing thing when you're walking into the grocery store and you know the only thing you can get is fucking water. Day five. I don't know if you could see. Little Italy. This is not the place in the world to be doing a 7-day fast. There's this bakery around the corner. It's called Ferrara. It's the number one bakery in the world. I wanted to go get some footage there, but I couldn't. So I'll see if I can pull up like some pictures of the pastries right now. It would be amazing. But yo, I'm not hungry, I feel good. Day five, about to go to a business meeting in New York City. By the way, I don't know if you guys know, but that's where I live. So, well, I live in Long Island, but from New York. So yeah, see you in a little bit. Football Sunday in the house. I'm freezing. Yep.
Nope. So.
I'm freezing. So, I'm finally understanding the freezing period. It's night five. I'm starting to feel like shit. Like now I'm strictly in it for this YouTube video. But like if I wasn't doing this YouTube video, I'd stop. Because it's too much. So funny because I'm in the grocery store right now. And like as soon as you walk in, like you see all these sweets. And like as much as I want to be like I'm hungry, to be honest, I'm just fucking pissed off. I'm just pissed off. Like bro, anything looks good. Like these pumpkin spice Cheerios, sure, you can get it. Bro, is this baby food? Let's do it. Baby food, I'm in. Like baby food, Ritz crackers. I don't even like Ritz crackers yet. But Ritz crackers sounds fucking delightful. What's this? Bran flakes? Bran's probably amazing. Bran flakes. Day six. Still feel really weak. Getting some water right now. Got a tea. Like I said, the only reason why I'm gonna push through is for you guys, because I think it's getting unhealthy now. It's day six. Officially decided that I'm going to end the fast. I'm still gonna make it to day seven, so I won't be eating anything today. I'll be getting my DEXA scan tomorrow. I'll probably eat sometime tomorrow around 1 or 2. I think I started my fast at hour 10 last Tuesday. So I'll be ending my fast 8-9 hours prematurely. I need food. I know I don't need food. I could certainly make the time. Like I said, the past 2 days, if you've been seeing the footage, I'm only doing this for you guys. I feel like I won. I did win. It was a 7-day fast, over 170 hours, 80 hours, something crazy like that. And now it's at the point where I feel like it's doing a little bit more harm than good. I don't really feel good. It's a very weird feeling. My body, I'm not even hungry, to be honest with you. I'm not hungry at all. I just feel like I need nutrients. All right, guys, this is officially the end of the video. Thank you guys for making it here. I hope it was a banger video. I'm gonna go into my final thoughts right now, but before we even do that, I wanna give a huge shout out to my sponsors for this video. I just signed with Bear Performance Nutrition. I never wanna make this page salesy. I actually used the products in the video. The electrolytes were amazing. I also wanna thank the DexaFit guys. In like a minute or so, I'll roll the transformation about how much body fat I lost, how much muscle mass I either gained or lost, how much weight I lost, which was actually pretty insane. I wouldn't have known all that shit without DexaFit. Both companies were kind enough to give like discount codes for this video, so I'll leave them below. They'll probably just be like Jake or something like that. Yeah, show some love. They're amazing, and I couldn't have done this without them. Getting into the actual final thoughts itself. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and start with the obvious. I'm diced the fuck up. I'm absolutely shredded. I'll do the physique update right now so you guys can see the before and the after. Yeah, so obviously you guys can see I'm not diced up at all. I have a nice amount of body fat. I have hair, you know, if you do the 7-day fast, you know, your body hair will just melt away. No, but all seriousness, you know, these are the rest of the days and you guys can kind of see. Around day four is when I started to notice like a real difference. But as you can see, now we're on day seven, final day. I look like Hugh Jackman. I look like Wolverine. This challenge is certainly not for weight loss, but if you do want to lose weight, this definitely will do it. Now, as far as what happened with the DEXA scan, I went from 16% body fat to 14.9%. I went from 209 pounds to 197 pounds. So we're looking at like 11 pounds of weight loss. I did lose 7 pounds of muscle. So we'll go into that with the cons because that's not good, 7 pounds of muscle. My visceral fat is at zero. And that just basically means that there's no fat around my organs. So what this fast is for is your overall health, cellular health, inflammation. It definitely did that. Now let's speak about the actual fast itself. So another positive, I felt extremely confident. The amount of self-respect that I have for myself, I really feel like people don't respect influencers and YouTubers because they don't think it's a real job. And I don't know a lot of people with
with a real job that would be willing to not eat for 7 fucking days, let alone skip a meal. So yeah, I'm just extremely confident and ready to take this channel to the next level. So confidence, self-respect, that's big. It made me not want to take shit from nobody. I'm a people pleaser. I like people. I'm an extrovert. There was a lot of messages that had to be sent to businesses and relationships and friends and even parents and conversations that had to be had that I was just afraid to have. But because of this challenge, if something has to be said, it was said. It was said. So now a lot of people speak about mental clarity with these types of fasts. To be honest with you, I really didn't feel it. There was a weird thing where I would get in a trance because I didn't really feel that good. I would get in a trance and I was able to get a lot of work done. So I will say that there was a trance-like state and a lot of work did get done, but I don't know if I felt that extreme focus like people say. And then probably the best thing about this fast for me, my joint pain was severely down. I have a very terrible back injury from college football and I felt a lot better doing this fast than when I eat food. You know, my body felt better. Cons, you guys saw the end of the footage. The last 3 days were a real struggle. I'm not gonna say I was in a really terrible place. I definitely could push through. I could probably go do more days right now, but I just felt for me, there was a point where it just got a little unhealthy and I felt my body needed nutrients. Obviously you saw I lost 7 pounds of muscle. That doesn't mean that it's all muscle. It could have been some water from the scan. It could have been some other things, but you know, it's never good to lose muscle. I worked very hard, a lot of years of college football and in the gym to build muscle. So I'm happy I'm ending this fast because I don't want to lose any more muscle. It's very bad for your social life, but it did make me appreciate, I want to read this because it is kind of important. It did make me appreciate the art of eating or the experience. I realized that eating isn't just about being hungry and getting calories in. It's about, you know, sharing a bottle of wine on a first date with a, you know, a beautiful woman, a beautiful man, being hungover on a Sunday watching football with your boys, having pizza, having some bagels, doing a Mexican themed taco night, you know, inside with your family and just making some homemade guacamole and just food is an experience. I'm so excited to just eat everything. I want to eat everything. Like literally, I want to try Indian food. I want to try the Japanese food. I want to try this, that. It definitely made me appreciate food a lot more. So those are pros and the cons. Obviously a lot more pros than there were cons. Final thoughts. I'm a little upset. I didn't take this more spiritually. I probably could have done a lot more meditation and breath work because a lot of people speak about the spiritual benefits versus, you know, day 4, day 5. I just wanted this to end. And I just started, I would just watch videos of people eating pizza. And, you know, I was so hungry. I just couldn't wait to eat. I'll never do this again. I'll say that right now, unless I'm feeling spiritually inclined. 3 days is the sweet spot. From now on, I'm definitely going to implement fasting into my lifestyle just because I saw how yoked I am and the appreciation of everything else that it did for me, as well as the, you know, actual benefits. From now on, I'll definitely be doing intermittent fasting every day, at least an 18 or a 20 hour fast every day. I'll be doing a 24 hour fast once a month, and I'll be doing a 3 day fast twice a year. Finally, guys, the main takeaway from this video, and again, I really appreciate you guys being here. I wanted to quit this so bad on day one. Once it got to night one and I was so hungry and I realized, oh my God, I have another 155 hours left. It was very demoralizing and I really wanted to quit. So I hope the main takeaway of this video is that you can do anything you put your mind to. I know that's corny if it's not backed by anything, but like I wanted to quit on day one and then I went another 150 hours of not eating. So you can do anything you put your mind to. We're a lot more powerful than you guys think you are. If you guys do subscribe, you guys will see moving forward my content. I know this video is fun, but my content is pretty serious. I had a very negative experience with panic attacks and anxiety after my college football career ended and I had to drop out. I'm all about mental health and self-help and personal development, following your dreams and just raising your ceiling, man, like getting after it. Like we're all supposed to do something great in this world. And you know, it takes doing challenges like this to get the confidence to remember that you are more powerful. And it doesn't matter what anyone else says, your friends, teachers, family, girlfriends, you can do it. Whatever it is, you can do it. Finally, I'm going to eat and like, comment, subscribe, please. I did this for you guys. Thank you.
Wow, I can't even believe I'm doing this. This is wild.
I think I'm breaking this fast the right way. I didn't start this fast the right way. You guys saw espresso martinis and veal parmesan. Also, shout out the Journey Podcast. I'll leave a link below. That's my personal podcast with my best friend who's filming right now, and it's banging.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Were you seeing that? But where's the sun? Get the sun.
Were you seeing that?
Bro, I'm chewing something. Oh my God. Bro.
That's OD. A
little bit of bone broth. End it on the Journey podcast.
That even tastes good. I was gonna say that's chicken bone broth is not good.
Tastes like Thanksgiving. Thank you guys, like, comment, subscribe. Hope you enjoyed the video, and see you guys on the next one.